that down. Let's go on to this. Francis Ford Coppola is going to go down in history as one of the greats, making two of arguably the greatest films. Some would say the absolute greatest films of all times, because a lot of people in certain film cinephile circles, the debate is only, is Godfather 1 the greatest movie of all time, or is Godfather 2 the greatest movie of all time? That's how important, that's how iconic, that is how legendary Francis Ford Coppola is, and nothing is going to change that. Of course, he had a passion project, the new movie Megalopolis, that he sold part of his vineyard, or sold his vineyard and used part of the proceeds of that to make his $120 million passion project. Now, things didn't look good early on. We remember we talked about this months ago. They played it for distributors at an industry event, and the distributors were like, what the fuck is this? And they were literally like, we don't know how to sell this. Like, what is this? And a lot of whispers started going around. Then they had that fiasco where they put out that trailer using fake critic quotes and right. stuff like that. Yeah. They got caught using it and all that kind of stuff. And the worry was, and I said, nobody's going to go see this movie. And they projected about $6 or $7 million, which is nothing. But apparently it made less than nothing. It made $4 million in its opening weekend. Mm. This comes just from the folks over at Variety, who wrote the following. Ticket sales for Megalopolis were less than initial projections of $5 million to $7 million, which would have been a financially disastrous anyway for the $120 million budgeted film. By comparison, Kevin Costner's mostly self-funded $100 million budget passion project Horizon American Saga Part 1 made almost three times as much, with $11 million over its opening weekend before tapping out with $36 million worldwide. As a result, plans for release of Part 2 were indefinitely paused. Guys, last week we talked about Transformers 1, a great movie, which we're going to talk more about in just a minute, but a great movie that cost $70 million to make. And we talked about how it flopped, making only, what did we say, $25 million opening weekend?
Yep. Yes.
Like a $70 million film opening to $25 million. And we said, this sucks because this movie's great, but it kind of fell on its face. Imagine you paid $50 million more than that and made five times less. This seriously has got to be a top 10 biggest flop of all time. Mm. Now, remember, I'm not talking about the quality of the movie. All right. I'm not saying anything about the quality of the movie. I'm just talking about the straight up numbers of the movie. And the straight up numbers are, this is a $120 million film.
Plus marketing.
Plus marketing.
Oh, plus distribution, because they paid the distributors.
Yeah, they had to. Whereas normally in movies, distributors pay the filmmakers for the right to distribute. Since nobody would wanted to distribute Megalopolis, the producers, Francis Ford Coppola, had to pay distributors to distribute it. That's not how the business works.
Ever.
Like, this was unheard of. Like, I'm sure maybe it's happened before.
Yeah.
But it certainly doesn't happen often. For this movie that they had to pay distributors to distribute, $120 million production budget, whatever the marketing budget cost on top of that, this thing made $4 million. What is or was the biggest flop of the year? Borderlands. Ray, how much did Borderlands make in its opening weekend?
8.6 million. Yeah.
8.6.
Yep.
The biggest flop of the year. It made more than double than Megalopolis did.
Oh,
wait. I want us to sit in the corner and think about what we did. I want you to think about this for a second. Borderlands. More than twice as many people went out to go see it than went to go see the new Francis Ford Coppola movie. Now I'm laughing and stuff like that. Lest any of you think I take joy in this. I really don't. I want to see every movie succeed. I do. Movies I don't like, I want to see succeed because that means other people enjoyed it. Movies I love, like Transformers 1, I obviously want to see those succeed. I want a god of the industry, like Francis Ford Coppola, to succeed. But, I mean, what can you do in the face of tragedy? But laugh. This thing made $4 million. $120 million budgeted film made with Giancarlo Esposito, with Adam Driver, Aubrey Plaza, with Lawrence Fishburne. It made $4 million, guys. That means less than about 500,000 people went to go see Megalopolis. Less than 500,000 people went to go see Megalopolis. If you want a real context for how bad that is, more people watched the John Campion show last week.
And we didn't make no $4 million. Or if we did, I didn't hear about it.
$20 million on it. More people watched the John Campion channel. More people watched the John Campion channel last week than went to go see Francis Ford Coppola's new movie. I mean, Madam Web, some people are saying it's like Madam Web. Madam Web blew this out of the water.
Oh, what I'd give to make Madam Web money.
Oh, totally make Madam Web money. Oh, that Morbius money's looking real good right now.
Yeah.
And look, I don't think, as people break down and do the autopsy, if you will, of Megalopolis, when it's all said and done, I don't think this was filmgoers rejecting Francis Ford Coppola. I don't believe that's true. I don't believe this is filmgoers reject Adam Driver. I don't believe that's true. I don't believe filmgoers are rejecting Giancarlo Esposito. I don't believe that's true. What I do think is true, and I bring this up all the time with different movies, and everybody always says I'm crazy, but time after time after time, it's proven to be right. You got to tell the damn audience what your movie's about. You got to tell, like, I watched the trailers for Megalopolis. I had no freaking idea what that movie was about. Now, apparently a bunch of people who did see the movie still have no idea what the movie's about.
They don't know.
Guys, we want to take a second to thank a sponsor of today's video, The Perfect Jean. Okay, so I've got to tell you about The Perfect Jean. These jeans are seriously a game changer. You know that feeling you get when you find a pair of jeans that fit so well that you almost forget that you're wearing them? That's what happened when I tried these. I'm not kidding. They're as comfortable as your favorite sweatpants, and they can slide on like them too, but they still look amazing. Look, as guys, we've all suffered through stiff, uncomfortable jeans, but The Perfect Jean is all about recusing, well, your gentlemanly area. These jeans are soft, stretchy, and they fit like they were custom made just for you. Because they've got an insane range of sizes, whether you're a skinny jeans kind of guy or rocking the bigger look. And they didn't just stop with jeans, they've got the perfect tee as well, with just the right amount of stretch to hide that beer belly, but still make you look great. It's finally time to stop crushing your balls in uncomfortable jeans by going to theperfectjean.nyc. Our listeners get 15% off your first order, plus free shipping, free returns, and free exchanges when you use the code Campia15 at checkout. That's 15% off for new customers at theperfectjean.nyc with the promo code Campia15. After you purchase, they'll ask you where you heard about them. Please support our show by telling them that we sent you. F your khakis and get The Perfect Jean. I mean, get this. This goes on to say this in Variety. With poor word of mouth, the film received a D+ on CinemaScore. Guys, when's the last time you ever heard of a movie getting a D+ on CinemaScore? I can't remember. I'm sure it's happened. Yeah. I'm just saying I cannot ever remember a movie getting a D+ on CinemaScore. I can't remember. Again, I'm not saying it's never happened. I'm sure it has. I'm just saying I can't ever remember that happening. I don't remember the last time a D+ CinemaScore got it. But anyway, with poor word of mouth, received a D+ grade on CinemaScore. Megalopolis opened in sixth place behind three holdover titles and the Indian Telugu language action film Devara Part 1. Reviews have been wildly divisive, with the New York Times calling the movie wonderfully out there and the Associated Press saying it's nearly impossible to digest in a single baffling viewing. But again, I just want to go back to the marketing of it. That the whole marketing of it, when you try to market a movie, it's like, look how artistic this thing is. People will not go. There's a reason why the great Denis Villeneuve's masterpiece, Blade Runner 2049. Why that masterpiece of a movie, nobody went to go see it. Why? Because the marketing never told anybody what the movie was about. Mm-hmm. Look, everybody, we're back in the world of Blade Runner. Great. So what's this movie about? Don't you worry about it. All you need to know is that we're back in the world of Blade Runner. Oh, well, then screw you then. I don't need to come to your movie.
Which wasn't a financially successful film to begin with.
So. Yeah, which the original wasn't to begin with. Right. But we've seen more and more. We've seen several circumstances where like a movie gives like that freaking one with Jennifer Lawrence and Javier Bardem, Mother.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Which was awful. But again, the trailers are just like, look how artistic this movie is. Nobody cares. People want to know, is this going to be a fun, engaging, you know, movie? What's this movie about? Just tell me what it's about. Don't give me away the spoilers. Tell me what the movie's about. The trailers for this were all over the place. There was nothing in those trailers. The only thing that was going to attract people to go see this is that you put the great name of Francis Ford Coppola on it. That's it. You should have made trailers that were telling people what it was about. And therefore, nobody went to go see it. Mm. People didn't like it. And $120 million movie, guys, that made $4 million on its opening weekend. And spoiler alert, it's not going to pick up steam. There's not going to be some big Avatar-like word of mouth where the box office actually goes up. It ain't going to happen. This is ruination.
No turnaropolis for them.
Yeah, no turnaropolis. No,
oh, sorry, that was really bad. I apologize. Monday, baby.
Monday. It's just, and it's heartbreaking to see. And you know what? I'm going to say this right now. I really hope. Because I hate it when guys like Kevin Costner and Francis Ford Coppola bet on themselves and put their money where their mouth is. These guys should be applauded for this and put their own money up to make their movies and get punished for it.
But here's my thoughts on that.
What's that?
I mean, it's not about, yes, it is dangerous to use your own money. But the problem is that I think they were surrounded by yes men and it was only their vision. And it was sort of like Lucas.
There was nobody there to tell them no.
There was no one to tell them no. And I think that was a big mistake. They should have still had people they could trust. And I don't think they had a conciliary on those.
And that's what you need. You really do. I mean, in using Francis Ford Coppola verbiage, you need a conciliary. You need a wartime conciliary. You need somebody who is there to be honest with you and whatever. But I mean, here's what I really hope. I really hope that Francis Ford Coppola is able to pick himself off the mat. Lick his wounds and make another movie, a $30 million, $40 million movie. Because I don't want, look, his legacy is already secure. He's the freaking man who made The Godfather. All right. American Zoetrope. He's the man. So that's fine and everything, but I don't want his last time in the ring to be Megalopolis. I really hope he makes one more. It doesn't have to be his greatest movie of all time, but I would love it if he could end his career on a high note rather than something. He deserves better. He deserves more. Mm-hmm. Yep. So hopefully he'd be willing to do that, but I wouldn't blame him at all if he maybe said, screw this.
Megalopolis 2.
build that franchise, man. Build that franchise and then do spinoffs. Do a spinoff of Aubrey Plaza's character when she was young, when she was a kid, right? Do a prequel.
Yeah. Anyway.
Guys, question is for you. What do you think about this? I mean, everybody knew that it wasn't going to do well, but I mean, it did even worse than people were saying. $120 million budget movie that made $4 million on its opening weekend, and it's not going to get any better. How do you guys feel about that? Whatever your thoughts are, jump down to the comment section below and let us know your thoughts. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching this video. Make sure you like the video, leave a comment, and subscribe to our channel. And don't forget, we have a daily podcast called The John Campia Show Podcast, available on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or your favorite podcasting app of choice. Go and subscribe to it today so it'll be there when you need it.